Every time it rains, Panties from heaven.
Shooby dooby.
Don't you know each cloud contains panties from heaven?
Shooby dooby.
You'll find your fortune falling all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is up, upside down and trade them for a package. If you want the things you love, you must have a pizza, holy baby. And when you hear thunder, don't run under a tree. It'll be panties.
Oh, we're here already.
Oh, hi.
Boy, Sam, and every time it rains, and don't you know it's crocodiles? Every time it rains, and don't you know it's crocodiles? You'll find your fortune falling all over town, all over town, all over town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down to live up.
Congratulations! World's best cup of coffee. You guys did.
Hey, Baba Hawboy. Ooh, Baba Hawboy. Woody woo. Ooh! I knew I'd get you. Let's go. Let's go.
Wow, that was a really festive video. I literally love the movie Elf.
I know, I was laughing the entire time.
Hi guys, welcome to the first ever Colonial TV Not So Very Late talk show. I'm your host, Kate Calderwood, with my co-hosts,
Taylor Breen
and Casey Wells. Tonight's show is about all about the holiday season. That's why I have my Darth Vader sweater on.
My Santa sweater.
And I've got my llama on.
And we are so excited to come to you live from the Shrewsbury High TV studio.
We have a great show tonight with our very own Student Council President, Nicole Carr Demetriou.
Plus, we have some special cookies that were made for some special SHS teachers.
And six of our very own seniors from the football and hockey team who are ready to compete against each other and test their holiday knowledge.
We're so excited to get started. Should we get right into it?
Obviously.
First up, yours truly takes on the lunchroom to ask the tough questions about the holiday season.
I'm pretty sure it wasn't just you who took on the lunchroom.
Hi. I'm Kate Calderon from Colonial TV, and we're going out in the commons to see what students are excited about for the holiday season. Come on.
Here we go.
Hi, what are you excited about for the holiday season?
I'm excited to spend time with my family and my friends.
Thanks, let's go.
Thank you.
What's on the top of your list?
I'm Taylor from the TV studio, and we're going to go to the study lunch and ask more questions about holidays.
So much fun filming this. Even though we had to refilm it due to sound issues, I think it turned out great.
Yeah, I do too. And we saw a lot of familiar faces out there from the TV studio.
It was very inspirational. Great work, guys.
Thanks. You know what they say, no pain, no gain.
Never say that again.
No, ever.
Anyway, we'll be right back after this commercial break.
Do you have bad hair, no friends, or a shot at getting a girlfriend? Then I have the solution for you. Salty Spray.
I'm Sean Salt, former All-Pro NFL lineman, rapper, and supermodel, and I've got the solution for you.
Just one spray of Salty Spray and your hair will look like this.
Oh my God, look at his hair. He must have used Salty Spray.
Thanks, bro.
Anytime.
Okay, Ryan, so what's your opinion about the Salty Spray?
You know, I think the Salty Spray is really good. Obviously, it works wonders on the hair like you have right now, so.
Yeah, all right. What are your opinions on Salty Spray?
Personally, I've been using it for a while now, and it's really good for my curly hair.
So, Connor, what's your opinion on the Salty Spray?
I think the Salty Spray is a very good product. Definitely helps out, and it really helped me.
All right, that's what I like to hear. Back to you.
But wait, if you buy one for $18.95 plus shipping and handling, you can get one more for free. Call 1-800-509-SALT to buy today.
Salty Spray is not responsible for any nausea, heartburn, permanent baldness, hemorrhoids, constipation, and depression, failed kidneys, and blindness. Talk to your doctor if you have any of these symptoms. These are not all the possible side effects and could...
Welcome back. I'm here with our very own Student Council President, Nicole Carr-Demetriou. So why don't you tell a little bit about your role and what you do?
Of course. So as president of student council, I take on a lot of roles on the council. Generally, I oversee every event that we do. I work very closely with my advisor, Mrs. Moisen, and with the administration here at SHS. And I also just, again, run events. I am in charge of my own committee on student council, the Student Outreach and Communications Committee. So we run a couple of leadership summits and a couple of other events to get the student body connected. So that's basically what I do.
Wow. You're like the backbone of the high school. That's crazy. Right. So what are you currently planning for 2022?
Yeah, so we have a ton of really fun events. We're actually in one right now. Tomorrow is anything but a backpack day. So I better see some creative nothing but a backpack options. Yes. Anything but. Anyways, that's going on this week. Super exciting. We also have our Valentine's Day event in February. We hope to have our Winter Leadership Summit, again, by my committee that we run. And then we also have our Spring Spirit Rally, Spirit Week, and a bunch of other fun events that I can't disclose yet.
Ooh, secret, right. Fun.
Right.
So what is your favorite event that has happened so far this year?
My favorite would probably be Colonial Way. After such a hard year with COVID, it's been really nice to get everyone together, even if it's outside, and just see the whole community together, see people without masks and be like, oh, that's what you look like.
Right.
it was a lot of work with the food trucks, with the club booths, but so much fun.
It was so much fun. I remember, like, it was just so organized and it was really thought out. So do you want to give us, like, a quick recap of what has happened, like, September to now, just to, like, the audience? You
know? Sure. So starting off strong in September, we had our Fall Spirit Week and Spirit Rally. And then moving on to October, we had our Coins for Cura Week, our Pink Day, again, Colonial Way. November was the Thanksgiving Supply Drive. We had a Blitz Day. And December, we have our Chill Out Week. And, yeah.
That's awesome. So your like acronym for the year is PIES. So do you want to explain that? Because I know there was a lot of confusion out there.
Sure. So PIES stands for Perseverance, Integrity, Empathy, and Self-Care. And those four phrases are really what Mr. Pizzidlo and I chose to focus on for this year as our guiding core values of the school. We hope that all students work to embody that in one way or another. The full phrase is keep your eyes on the PIES. So it's a fun like bakery theme. So any chance we get, we try to incorporate something with bakery themed things in our Stugo events.
Yeah, that's like a really important message. On a less important message, what's your favorite pie?
I would say my favorite pie is probably apple pie, but
so
I think cherry pie looks delicious. I haven't gotten to
you
try it yet.
You need to try cherry pie though. Like it's my favorite. Though.
Right,
like,
so you need to make me in and I'll try it.
I can't bake, I'll try. So what event has been the most rewarding to plan?
Yeah, so as I said, Colonial Way, obviously really rewarding. We put a ton of work into that. Also, the Spirit Rally. This year was the first time that we held it outdoors. So that was really cool that although it was so much work.
What was that like to make like from indoor to outdoor?
Yeah, so traditionally when we had it indoors, we'd have a setup of what the gym is going to look like. We have markers of this is where tug of war starts, this is where it ends. Mm-hmm. And when it was outdoors and on the football field, obviously that's way bigger space. So we had to mark off like the 40 yard meter line, whatever. So that was a big adjustment, just figuring out the spacing of everything.
Yeah, I bet. So as we're wrapping up the interview, I wanted to mention one more thing. So you spent a good amount of time here at the TV studio, is that correct?
I did.
So I was just curious, out of just pure curiosity, if you remember this
Oh,
project.
Goodness. Yes, I do.
Oh, would you like to explain the context?
Yeah, so I was formerly known as ETS News' first weather girl here at the TV studio, and I loved it here. It's so nice to be back in here. It's like this is my second home.
We are really so happy to have you, and we miss you, our storm team.
You.
Oh, my God. Now some of our fellow crew members have a wonderful idea to give thanks and love to our awesome staff. Let's take a look on how they did this.
Welcome to the SHS Baking Show. My name is Sydney.
And my name's Lyndon.
A big theme of the holidays is appreciation and gratitude. So a way we wanted to show appreciation for the teachers here at SHS is by making them cookies. All right, let's get started. First of all, wash our hands. So you're probably wondering what we're going to be putting on these cookies. We're going to be putting the teachers' faces on them. Ooh,
that's too many sticks. That's a lot of butter. I found the teaspoons and the spoons and the teas. You ready? Ready? Yeah. It looks like scrambled eggs.
Yeah.
Wow.
So they don't see me.
They don't see me. Wow. Oh, hi. I baked something. You want a bite? These are our makeshift cookie cutters. Do you want to make a hand?
Yeah. Compare hand sizes.
Okay, let's make the frosting. Continue wrapping up everything here and finishing that up. So that is going to end our baking segment. And now we're going to move on to watching the reactions of the teachers. We've already gotten some before recording this, but excited to see some more. So we can go to that.
Shut the front door.
That's so awesome. Oh, I love it. Massive little scurvy. Oh. Yeah, that's adorable. Oh, there's no candy bars. Oh my god, thank you. Shut up, is that me? Oh my god. That's the cutest thing I've ever seen.
Is this me?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, you guys made a
try and spot the real Mr. Sack.
Yeah, wow. That's very difficult.
It's impossible.
It's very challenging.
Yeah.
And then,
how cute is that?
Thank you so much. You guys are so sweet.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Thank you so much. That's so nice of you.
I give air hugs for all you guys. Thank you guys so much.
Oh, this is the sweetest.
You guys are the best. You're the best. And I'm going to hug the cameraman.
And a sticker.
All
right, let's start the trivia contest. Tonight we have two teams of three here to compete against each other and see who has more holiday knowledge. We'll start with Team A. What are your names and your team name?
I'm James.
I'm Connor.
I'm Caleb.
And we're the Goons.
Nice. And Team B, what are your names and what is your team name?
I'm Matt.
I'm Cam.
I'm Jack.
We are the Geese.
Nice. And here are the rules. Each team will get a question, and if they get it right, they get a point. If they get it wrong, the other team has a chance to steal. We'll start with Team Geese. Here's your first question. What is Santa's full name?
Nicholas Claus.
Correct. Team Goons, you're up. All right, Team Goons, here's your first question. What day is Christmas?
Wait, the date?
The date.
December 25th?
Correct. Nice. All right, Team Geese, what year did the movie Elf come out?
I know it.
You do? Yeah.
2003.
Correct. Hey, you look familiar too. All right, Team Goons. When was the first year the New Year's Eve ball drop was?
1982.
Okay.
Wrong. Team Geese, you have a chance to steal.
1969?
Wrong. It was 1907.
I didn't know they had balls back then. I was
close to 40. All right, Team Geese. How long is Hanukkah?
Oh, I got this.
9 days.
Wrong. Team
Eight
Goons.
Days.
Correct. Yes. Team Goons have stolen the point. All right, Team Goons, your question again. When is Kwanzaa celebrated?
December 26th. To January 1st.
Correct. Nice, Team Goons. All right, Team Geese, you need to catch up. Who is the voice of the conductor in the Polar Express?
Oh, Tom Hanks.
Correct.
No, I was going to guess that.
All right, Team Goons, which department store was featured in Miracle on 34th Street?
TJ Maxx.
Wrong. Team Geese, do you have a guess?
Macy's.
Correct.
You guys should have gotten
it. Nice. All right, Team Geese, how much money does the average American spend on holiday gifts? We'll give you a 100-point like difference. You can go below or above.
$450.
Wrong.
Is it above or below that?
Could you repeat the question,
total.
Please?
The question is, how much money total does the average American spend on their holiday gifts? It is above Team Geese's answer.
Which was, what was their answer?
$450.
$700?
Wrong. Like $1,200. It was $1,000.
I was going to say
that. Right, so.
That's silly.
Okay, Team Goons, your question. What is the highest grossing Christmas movie?
Okay, that means the movie that has made the most.
Yeah.
I want to make that clear.
All right, thanks. That's a good gal.
Yeah. All right, Team Goons, what's your answer?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Wrong. Oh. Team Geese, what is your answer?
What are you going to say?
Just the Santa Claus.
Wrong. Incorrect. The answer was Home Alone.
Oh, that was a gimme. Yeah.
All right, now we're going into movie quotes. Team Geese, what quote is this movie from? You stink. You smell like beef and cheese. You don't smell like Santa.
That's the Santa Claus.
Elf.
Oh. Elf. Correct.
Oh, shit.
Okay, Team Goons. This is not a movie quote, but who sang the Hanukkah song on Saturday Night Live?
Adam Sandler.
Correct. Adam Sandler. Correct. Here's another movie quote. What movie is this quote from? Eat My Rubber.
Can you repeat the question?
Eat My Rubber.
What movie is this quote from? Eat My Rubber.
Are we allowed to ask?
It is a holiday movie. No.
So it's a holiday movie.
Yes.
It's not a Christmas movie.
Could okay. be.
That, it could be.
I say Nicholas Claus.
Detest Christmas.
What's that one? Nick. Fuck. Go with yours.
Who are you?
Chris Mall Family Christmas.
Okay. Yeah, I like that one.
We're going to go with Chris Mall Family Christmas.
I mean, yes, correct. Not the name of the movie, but we'll give it to you. The correct answer is Christmas Vacation.
I think tomato.
All right. Team Goons, here's a movie quote. Keep the change, you filthy animal.
So easy, Home Alone.
Home Alone.
Correct. All right, now the next portion is finish that lyric. Team Geese, you're up first.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be.
As he could be. Was alive as he
You don't got it.
Any guesses?
Yeah, well, was loved Christmas.
No, that is not wrong. Team Goons, do you have an answer? Oh, Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be.
Yeah, I only know a wooden pipe and a button nose. A wood pipe and a button nose. And
no, that is also not correct.
Eyes made out of coal.
The correct lyric is, and the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me.
I could never.
That is a bomb.
No, there's too many words there. Too many words.
Okay. Next one. Team Goons. Dashing through the snow on a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way.
Hey. Bells on Bobtail's ring.
Making spirits bright. What fun it is to laugh and sing.
A sleighing song tonight.
Correct!
Oh!
Jingle bells.
All right, last question for Team Geese. Here's your song. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square in the frosty air.
I thought the beginning was going to be Rudolph, but I don't think it.
What a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away.
Correct. Yes.
No way.
And now, Team Goons, your last question. Okay. In the meadow, we can build a snowman. We'll pretend that he is Parson Brown.
Sing it.
You had
it.
Sing it.
Sing the line.
You got it,
Connie. Wait, sing it again.
In the meadow we can build a snowman. We'll pretend that he is Parson Brown.
Da-na-na-na, Mary, you snowman.
Does not count.
Sing it again.
I don't know. I just
you had it. You had it. Sing it.
We say Mary, you say no man.
Correct enough.
Yeah! Yeah!
I could have stole that.
Oh. All right, so you both are tied, and we have a quick tiebreaker for you. Which team can name all the reindeer on Santa's sleigh?
Oh, Vixen, Dasher, Dancer.
No, you can't. Wait,
raise your hand, please.
Raise your hand.
Team Geese?
It's all you, brother.
There's Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blixen. Vonner and
Donner. Wrong. Team Goons? Team Goons, take it away.
Rudolph. You got Rudolph. Prancer, Dancer, Vixen.
Is Donald?
Dancer.
Glancer.
Dancer. Yeah, you're weird.
Prancer. Cupid. Vixen.
Connor.
How many are we at?
Donna.
Five, I think.
You got all.
Well, you said
neither team got all of them, so we will end this game in a tie.
Are you kidding?
Thank you. Thank you to everyone for playing. We want to thank you both for participating. You did a great job. We'll be right back after another commercial break.
Thank you, guys.
Do you feel like you can't dribble the ball? Do you feel like you can't even make a simple shot?
Do you ever feel slow? Do you ever feel extremely useless?
Do you feel nervous during games? Does any sort of physical activity destroy your body?
Now introducing the brand new Air Spruce. It comes with breaking edge technology, provides ultimate comfort, and increases your athletic ability to the extent of your imagination.
You can cross up opponents with ease with these new shoes. Oh!
These shoes stink. Air Spruce are way better.
Dang! I've never played better until I've had these shoes on.
Brand new Air Spruce, only $179.99. Air Spruce have a 1-week warranty and is not responsible for any medical or insurance issues. Shoes may cause severe foot pain, loss of circulation, triple E-like symptoms, nausea, and may cause abrupt mood swings.
Air Spruce, buy now!
All right, so we ended that in a tie, so we're going to need to ask one more question for our teams because they did not want a tie for that one. They're going to tap our teacher, Ms. Herbert's, hand to see who gets it right first. The question is, who played the Grinch in the live-action movie? Team Goons! Correct! Congratulations to Team Goons!
Yay! Now that put me in the holiday spirit. We would like to thank everyone for watching our first ever live Colonial TV, Not So Very Late show.
We would also like to thank Ms. Herbert and Greg for helping us put it all together. This was so much fun, and we can't wait to see you next month.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true.
Just one thing I need, and I don't care about the Happy holidays.
Have a great break.
Happy holidays!
I don't want a lot for Christmas.